This is the new Wyze Outdoor camera. It's weather resistant, battery powered, 1080p, and priced at just 50 bucks. I'm Ben from AuthenTech, and let's check it out. Now, first up, I've been a huge Wyze fan for many years now. They make good quality products for super budget-friendly prices. After their $25 indoor camera exploded with popularity, they finally made an official outdoor camera, and it has some really great features, plus a few downfalls. Here's my honest review. First, let's understand pricing, as it's a little complicated. The first camera that you buy must include the base station. The bundle is $50. If you buy additional cameras, those are 10 bucks cheaper at just $40. However, as of right now, a base station can only handle 4 cameras max, though they told me that they're actively trying to tackle this problem to allow more. The positive side of this hub is it connects directly to your router via wired Ethernet, and then the Wyze camera wirelessly connects to the base station via what they told me, a proprietary Wi-Fi protocol. A nice benefit of this setup keeps your Wi-Fi traffic clear for other smart devices in your home. And I want to drive this point home. I've tested a ton of other Wi-Fi cameras, and they all struggle with Wi-Fi connectivity issues at times, which can be very frustrating for a security camera. This hub connection seems to offer a pretty sweet workaround if you don't go the PoE route. The major downside, though, until they unlock that expansion for more cameras, you'll need to buy more hubs for more cameras. For the average user, just 4 cameras might be sufficient, though you'll probably have some blind spots on your property, just be aware. Another key detail, these are not recording 24/7 security footage. These Wyze outdoor cams are more the approach of event-based recordings only, which again, might be fine for the average user. So here's how it works. Since there's PIR, motion detection, it records the clip and auto-saves to the cloud for 14 days free. I love when cloud storage is free. Plus, the video can be backed up to an SD card in the hub. That video clip records for a duration of only 12 seconds though, and then there's a cooldown period which you can set in the app, 1, 3, or 5 minutes. This means it won't record another clip until that cooldown period has passed. The main idea, I believe, is let's say a bad guy comes on your property. The Wyze will turn on, record that clip of activity, and that will hopefully be sufficient in case you ever need to reference that footage. The risk, though, I found on my Wyze, it wouldn't start recording the motion activity right away. There's often a bit of a delay, even up to 5-10 seconds sometimes, and a 12-second clip is just a short amount of time. This could very easily miss the most important moment, and you just never know. Hopefully, with continued updates, this might be improved. And I understand the difficult balance here, since this is a battery-powered camera after all, and most people don't want to be recharging the thing every couple days or weeks, and the camera needs some tight restrictions like this to even come close to that 3 to 6 month rated battery life. And they say average usage is 10 to 20 event videos per day. Now, on the inside of this camera are 2 2600 milliamp hours battery, which when I first saw this, I thought it was a typo. That's 5200 milliamp hours. And for comparison, the iPhone 11 Pro Max biggie size is under 4000. So that's a lot of battery jammed inside this tiny camera. Speaking of the design, the Wyze outdoor camera is fantastic. I kind of like that Death Star look, and its small size is easy to mount just about anywhere. There's flexible pan and tilt options for capturing the right angle, though I personally kind of prefer the magnetic ball joint approach better. And remember, this thing is completely wireless, so we could mount it on a back fence or up in a tree or just about anywhere. There's two-way audio, which is nice to have. It has night vision distance up to 25 feet. I wish it was a wider angle though, squeeze as much as possible into camera frame. Overall, video quality gets a B+ in my opinion. It's not game-changing clarity or dynamic range, but for the cheap price tag, it's pretty dang good. I really like their motion tagging system for easy highlighting of movement. I like the time-lapse feature, made easy to capture sunrise, sunsets, or anything else you can think of. There's a slick travel mode, lets you record videos while on the go, so no internet or base station is required. The mounting system is pretty sweet, it snaps to its base via strong magnets, easy to angle, and that base piece mounts to walls or ceilings with screws. Plus, they added a 1/4-20 tripod mount to the base of the camera, which I always love to see. This way, we can easily attach it to just about any camera clamp. I'm also a fan of solar panels, and it makes sense to have one available for a wireless outdoor camera like this. Now, I tried testing two different panels I had on hand, and it was pretty strange. At times, it showed that the camera was charging successfully. But then, if I left it on for longer periods, the battery percentage sort of dropped down. I have a suspicion that Wyze is working on something official, just nothing out yet. They even say in their FAQ that the camera will function while charging, however this is not recommended as the camera is built with the intention of running primarily off of its battery power. Also keep in mind, when the camera is plugged in, the weather seal is broken, so this could possibly cause issues if exposed to moisture. The Reolink Argus 2, another wire-free weatherproof camera I've reviewed previously, actually has an optional solar panel that features a waterproof wire cover, which is a great option. Its overall cost is a bit more than the Wyze Outdoor, but it's a viable option to consider. My last wishlist item, I hope Wyze can work on a better timeline scrubbing and playback viewer. For example, the recent events viewer is pretty good. It's easy to filter options and scroll through dates and times, but maybe these little thumbnails could be animated motion, easier to find what we're looking for. And another little funky bug I found, I started recording the sweet flower time lapse, ended the clip early, and I lost the whole video. Nothing was saved to the SD, so that was a bummer. And the last big one that the community has been asking for years, please give us a first-party desktop or web app to remotely monitor. Now, in my opinion, Wyze Outdoor is a fantastic budget-friendly option for home security, but healthy expectations need to be set. I admit I'm a bit of a security camera snob, so I like 4K or higher resolution, PoE, NVR, 24/7 recording. However, when my friends and family are looking for a much simpler and cheaper option, I usually point them in the direction of Wyze. Now let me know what you guys think or drop any of your questions down below. I'll try my best to respond, and I'll see you guys next time.